You can delete either your Gmail or your entire Google account. But before you do so, make sure to download all your data. Also, if you deleted your account within 20 days, there's a chance you can still recover it. So I have a Google account here that has access to many Google applications, such as the Google Drive. You can see I have many files here. This Google account also stores some of my photos. And it is also linked to my Gmail account. To start the deletion process, click on your Google account avatar and select Manage your Google account. Sometimes there are way too many options and menus to look for a specific thing, so the easiest thing to do is search for it by typing delete and selecting one of the options. Or you can find it under Data and Privacy on the left. Then scroll down to Data from the apps and services you use. You can either select the option to download your data here or select the Delete a Google Service option. You will see the type of individual services that you have linked to your Google account and that you can delete individually without deleting the entire Google account. At the top, you still have the Download Your Data option. It is always a good practice to download or backup your data. You never know when in a couple of days you will realize that you had something very important stored there. Let's request a copy of our data. We are being taken to Google Takeout. Here you have a list of data stored in Google. Pretty much your life. Select the ones you want to download. I have 46 possible items, and guess what? I will select them all just to be safe. Then I will select Next Step. At this point, I can specify how I want this data to be sent to me. I can request it to be sent to me through email or save it to my drive, etc. You can actually schedule automatic downloads every 2 months of your account. Specify file type and file size. File size is important because exports larger than the size specified will be split into multiple files. So if your Google account is 10 gigabytes and I choose 2 gigabytes as my file size, I will get 5 separate files. Once ready, click Create Report. You will see a message telling you that Google is creating a copy of all the files and it may take some time. Since I requested it to be sent to me, I will go to my Gmail. Consider this, for my very small account, it took over an hour to create my download file. I will open the email from Google Takeout to download my files. Once you sign in, you can proceed with the download. When I unzip it, I can see number of folders for different data type stored in my Google account. Let's double check that I have all my data before I go back and delete my account. Most important order of business, my photos. And I can see that all the pictures are there. The second most important data for me are my files on G Drive. And I can see that they are all there as well. My calendar, mail, and Chrome data is also saved there. Now I feel at ease deleting my Google account because I have a copy of all my data. To delete Gmail or any other single Google application, we have to go back to Data and Privacy, scroll down to delete a Google service. When I select the trash can to delete Gmail, I'm asked to provide an alternative email to be linked to the Google account. Gmail is one service under the Google account umbrella, and you need an email address to sign in to Google account. So since we are deleting this one, we need to provide an alternative email address. Otherwise, we won't have access to our Google account. Let's say we want to delete our entire Google account. Before you do so, click on the summary of your services under Apps and Services. Here I can see what kind of files and accounts I have under this Google account. You want to check this before you delete your account so you don't lose important information. In our case, we already downloaded all of this, so we can select the Delete Google Account under More Options. You will see a summary of all the content that will be deleted. Note the item at the bottom that you need to confirm, which states that you are still responsible for any financial transactions that are linked to this Google account. After you read and agree with both warnings, click Delete Account. At this point, if you sign in again, you will receive a message that your account was recently deleted and you may be able to recover it. Google doesn't provide information on how long before you won't be able to recover your data, but per couple online sources, you probably won't be able to get your account back if it's longer than 20 days or so. If, on the other hand, you select the continue option, you will receive a confirmation that your account was deleted. At this point, you can still recover your account. If it has been a few days though, you can use the Google Guidebooks to walk you through the account recovery options. Or type in URL g.co/recover to start the recovery process. Good luck and thanks so much for watching.